Trump cuts admittance of refugees down 87% since taking office. Trump promised to make America great again. Part of that promise included putting America first. When it comes to the safety and national security of Americans, our safety comes first. Compared to Obama, when it comes to reducing the number of refugees, Trump has done a significant job drastically reducing the number allowed into our country. Of course, Trump promised there would be strong differences when it came to the travel ban too. It wouldn't be a permanent ban, rather, one that would be in place until we could be sure that the people admitted into this country weren't Islamic terrorists coming to do harm. Numbers are now coming in that show Trump is definitely keeping his word. The number of refugees admitted into the United States has decreased sharply, Fox News reported. For the first month of fiscal year 2018, the number of refugees admitted has fallen by a whopping 87%. There were 9,945 refugees admitted during the first months of fiscal year 2017, compared to only 1,242 for this fiscal year. Breaking the numbers down further, the number of Muslims admitted as refugees dropped from 45% to 23%. While President Barack Obama had capped the number of refugees admitted into this country at 110,000, Trump lowered that number to 45,000. Trump's limit went into effect last month. Time and time again, Trump made it clear that he would do whatever is necessary to protect American citizens, even if that meant lowering the number of refugees taken in by the country. When you look at Europe, and the wave of violent attacks they have endured over the past few years, many of whom entered through the refugee program, Trump is absolutely right for taking this stand. Thanks to a large ocean, we are more insulated from this threat than Europe, but that protection won't last if we admit people without running extensive background investigations. While America will always reach out to help those around the world who are suffering, at some point we have to make sure we aren't helping others at the expense of the safety of our own people. While liberals can scream, cry, and protest all they want, this is their new reality, so they better get used to it. If liberals want someone to blame, they should look to Obama. After all, it was under his watch that the Middle East fell to pieces. His lack of leadership caused an entire region of the world to implode. If things weren't so bad over there, we wouldn't need to have extreme vetting to ensure that we weren't letting in terrorists. More Christian refugees admitted under Trump. More Christian than Muslim refugees have been admitted to the United States in the first months of the Trump administration, reversing a trend that had seen Muslims outnumber Christians in the final fiscal year under President Barack Obama. A Pew Research Center analysis of U.S. State Department refugee data has found. From Donald Trump's first full day in office on January 21 through June 30, 9,598 Christian refugees arrived in the U.S., compared with 7,250 Muslim refugees. Christians made up 50% of all refugee arrivals in this period, compared with 38% who are Muslim. Some 11% of these arrivals belong to other religions, while about 1% claim no religious affiliation. The religious composition of refugees to the U.S. has been shifting on a monthly basis as well. In February, Trump's first full month in office, Muslims accounted for 50% of the 4,580 refugees who entered the U.S., and Christians made up 41% of arrivals. By June, Christians, 57%. Made up a larger share of arrivals than Muslims, 31%. This stands in contrast to fiscal 2016, when a record number of Muslim refugees entered the U.S. and Muslims made up a higher share of admitted refugees than Christians, 46% versus 44%, respectively. However, the shift in the religious composition of refugees since January falls in line with longer-term trends. Between fiscal years 2002 and 2016, Christians outnumbered Muslim refugees in all but 3 years, 2005, 2006 and 2016. The religious affiliation of refugees has come under scrutiny since Trump first issued an executive order on January 27 announcing restrictions on people traveling into the U.S. from 7 majority Muslim countries, Iran, Iraq, Libya, Somalia, Sudan, Syria and Yemen, a temporary halt of the U.S. refugee resettlement program, and a new, lower cap on refugee admissions, set to 50,000 people annually. Overall refugee admissions to the U.S. in fiscal 2017, which ends September 30, are on pace to fall below the 85,000-person ceiling established by the Obama administration for fiscal 2016, a year that saw 84,995 actual refugee arrivals. At the same time, arrivals for the current fiscal year are already nearing the new cap set by Trump in his executive order. As of June 30, the U.S. had already admitted 49,255 refugees. However, under the Supreme Court's recent order, refugees with close family members in the U.S. may continue to enter the U.S. even after the new cap is reached. In the first months of the Trump administration, the top countries of origin for refugees have been the Democratic Republic of the Congo, 3,235, followed by Burma, Myanmar, 2,470, Iraq, 1,923, Somalia, 1,879, Syria, 1,779, and Ukraine, 1,603. These six countries have made up two-thirds, 67%, of all refugees entering the U.S. since January 21, 2017. Of these, three are majority Muslim origin countries, Iraq, Somalia and Syria. But since April, when Christian refugees topped 50% of all refugee arrivals to the U.S., there has been a further shift. From April through June, Iraq is the only Muslim-majority nation among the top six origin countries. Other leading countries during this time have been the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Burma, Ukraine, Bhutan, and Eritrea. You can bet the next step for President Trump when it comes to immigration will be to have the diversity visa program abolished. A program that the recent attacker in NYC came into our country on, along with at least 20-25 other of his friends.